What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. So today, I just want to address some drama that has come up in the comments of some of my videos regarding some of the mechanics that I have used in the past. So I'm sure a lot of you know that I recently got my harmonic balancer replaced by Cordis Performance Racing here in Tempe, Arizona. And a lot of you guys seem to throw a lot of shade their way in the comments because it didn't fix my issue. Those are two unrelated things. So they did exactly what I asked them to do, and that was to replace the harmonic balancer. I did not tell them to diagnose any other issues on the car. In fact, when I went to go pick up the car, the owner of the company had gone out on a test drive in my car and didn't even know that I was there. So had he known that I was going to be coming there, he would have called me ahead of time and told me some of the underlying issues that he discovered on the test drive. The power steering, even though a lot of you guys were commenting that they had to take apart the steering rack in order to get to the harmonic balancer, while that is true, the issue that I'm having with my power steering is completely unrelated. The fluid level is topped off, everything is spinning, the pump isn't even making a noise, to be honest with you, and it's kind of just a weird thing. I'm sure the pump is probably the original power steering pump. The car does have over 120,000 miles, so that's just something to be expected, especially since I'm running quite substantially larger front tire than came stock on the car. So that in itself is a lot harder on the whole power steering system than it would be otherwise if it had the stock specs. So I just want to clear the air and make sure that you guys understand that they did not cause the issue with my power steering. That's number one. Two, I mentioned that they wanted me to take some pictures of the underside of my car, and that was after I had already shown up there and before the owner of the company, Joe, came back from the test drive. I actually met him out in the parking lot as he was getting out of my car, and he was explaining these things to me. So he said, you know, obviously I was picking up the car right then. So he said, you know, once you get a chance and get it home, he knew I had the Quick Jacks here at the house. So he said, hey, if you shoot me a couple of pictures, I can give you some pointers and some things that are to think about. So that was that. Really nothing else to go over there. Obviously, we know that they had the car up on the lift, but at the time, we didn't know about those issues until after it was already completed and it was on the dyno and they heard the noise. Also, a couple of people, for some reason, wanted to point out that they didn't diagnose my air conditioning issues. Again, I did not tell them to diagnose my air conditioning problems. In fact, I would never do that because that's not really their specialty, especially on older Corvettes. And regarding the air conditioning, let's talk about another mechanic that I have used in the past, and that is Bromley's Corvettes. They used to be in Scottsdale, Arizona. They just recently moved to Gilbert, Arizona. I've known Doug for quite a long time. He does a lot of good work, and just like any shop, he has his problems as well. But regarding my air conditioning, this happened probably 3 years ago. A lot of you guys that have been with the channel for a long time know that I spent a lot of money trying to get my air conditioning to work. And just like my time with Cordis Performance Racing, Bromley also did exactly as I told him to, nothing else, nothing more. He replaced pretty much everything in the system, and we came to a determination that there's just an electrical gremlin in the system. At the time, I was broke. The car had really put me in a hole, and I just flat out didn't want to spend any more money on that issue. The air conditioning was not a priority for me at the time. Honestly, the air conditioning still is not a priority for me at the time, because I don't really drive the car that much in the summertime anyways, because it's so damn hot here, guys. Honestly, driving the car when it's 120 degrees outside, you lose close to 40% of your horsepower. So it's honestly not even that fun to drive the car in the summer, even if you had air conditioning. So that's not really a deal for me. So the air conditioning has been like on my far, far, far back burner for the past 3 years. I honestly don't even care about it. I'd rather build the car, make it as clean as possible, get as much horsepower out of it as I can. Obviously, you know, I upgraded a lot of the suspension parts. I'm doing, you know, basically a full restoration on the car, and the air conditioning is probably the last thing, other than maybe the radio. I've probably turned on my radio once since I've owned the car. I could care less about music in the car. The symphony out the four exhaust pipes is plenty enough for me. So I just wanted to clear the air that those two things, I know a lot of you guys in the comments, a lot of you haven't, but a lot of you have thrown shade towards Bromley and Cordis Performance Racing. And I just want to say, I just want to put it to bed that neither of them have screwed me over in any way. Both of them have done exactly as I asked them to. Nothing more, nothing less. And I paid them what they earned, and that's that. Now, on a related side note, there's been a lot of people that have been saying that I'm just throwing parts and money at the car to try to make the problem go away. Well, generally, that's how things get fixed, is that you replace parts and you pay money for those parts. So cars are not always 100% straightforward. You know, when you have a mysterious sound, sometimes it's a little hard to pick up on it. How many times have you taken your car to the Chevy dealership and you get it back and it still has the issue, or it has a different issue? And those are certified Chevrolet mechanics. I'm just a dude in his garage who does this stuff, you know, learning by himself. So I take a lot of pointers from you guys. A lot of you guys gave me, you know, tips on what to replace. 90% of you guys were asking me to replace the harmonic balancer. I did so. It didn't solve the issue. And that's kind of that. I mean, there's really nothing else to say. There's nobody to blame but myself. Please don't get upset at anybody other than me. So it is what it is. And then one final point that I wanted to make is that these are older cars that we're talking about. The C5, the newer of the two, is a 1998. So we're looking, you know, that's going on 23, 24 years old now. Basically, when I first bought this car, everything had to be replaced. You know, over the course of the past 3 years, I've replaced a lot of stuff on this car. The harmonic balancer was probably one of the older parts on the car, so probably a good thing that I replaced it anyways. But, you know, older cars just have stuff go bad sometimes, and sometimes it's just what happens. You know, anybody who is in the hobby who's ever built a car, you could probably understand this. You know, if you get a new Corvette every 5 years, you probably don't see this kind of stuff as often, because newer cars generally don't have as many issues. You know, if you got a 66 Corvette Stingray, it's going to take some maintenance once in a while. You know, it's a lot more than a 2017 Stingray would. So that's where I'm going to end off this video. So sorry for the big rant today, but I just wanted to clear the air. It's something that's been on my shoulders for quite a long time regarding Bromleys. And then when this came up with Cordes in the last video, I didn't want you guys to smear their name. They do a lot of great work, and so does Bromleys. And any shop is going to have their fair share of problems and problem cars, and honestly, problematic owners as well. So that's going to do it for today's video. I will get this issue figured out. I promise you guys. In fact, I think I have a pretty good lead on something that may be an easier fix than I'm thinking about. So stay tuned for that. We're going to go over it in full detail. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. And until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.